Baltic sort, this is Serpy. Now today I'm going to be talking about some new laws the government tried bringing that, to be honest, them extra spooky. And we know say this not go really, right, been a headline news. Most Jamaicans are the first time I go hear it, but I go telling them why these laws, right, should catch the attention of every Jamaican. Before I'm going to that, most of you would have noticed yesterday that the comment section was turned off. That wasn't me, that was YouTube. I don't know why. Let me say, I don't know which white phone I am for them. Hopefully it's back on for this video, especially for this topic, right? For the people, I mean, if you get them voices heard, but if not, well, the show must go on, right? So, doing some reading online, I came across a story in RGR. And I thought to myself, hold on, this looks spooky. The government, right, and to be precise, right, the Cyber Intelligence and Incident Response Branch of the Ministry of National Security, right, are saying they want some amendments to the current laws. I'm going to show you how these laws, right, can seriously affect new media. What is new media? That's like your vloggers on YouTube, Instagram and them things. Right. I'm going to tell you, right, what I think is the possible ulterior motive for all of this. Listen to this clip. This is coming from the senior policy director. Check this out and listen very carefully.
The first recommendation that we're putting to the committee is to amend section 9, subsection 1, which treats with the use of computer for malicious communication, to include data of a particularly graphic nature, such as violent events resulting in death or serious injury or the maiming of a person or persons, which may be grossly offensive or could cause psychological harm to a person.
Now, let me stop right there, so I can go break it down piece by piece. Don't worry, there's more. I can go check out the rest over RGR, by the way. All right, that's where we get this from. You hear him just a while ago? I wonder if I really hear with the man just a while ago. They might try to amend the law, right, for have stiffer penalties, right, for data of a particular graphic nature, such as violent events resulting in death or serious injury, right, because it can have serious psychological impact on recipients. Really? So in other words, you know, when time the big incidents them go on and then the video them come out afterwards and then people can look upon them and scrutinize them, apparently those can have serious psychological impacts. And we know the government cares about the psychological impact on the people might have. We know that, right? Who believe that? Who believe when this policy was coming up, Jamaica's politicians and people in the Ministry of National Security said, boy, we sure care about the psychological impact this is having on the people of Jamaica. Who believe that? You believe that? Link me for a unicorn. Matter of fact, link me for two. Serious psych? Let me tell you why this is serious. Why this is dangerous. When governments are trying to bring in laws and policies to stifle free speech or for, you know, cut off an avenue that can potentially hurt them down the road, them not gonna come out and say it directly. No government ever come out and say, listen, we don't want to expose it one day, you know. Listen, we don't want to know. Listen, we want to make sure the people can protect themselves from this, so we just take all them guns. That's, no government says that. Them come out and them find an issue that is genuine, and then them say, oh, we're gonna bring in these new tougher laws, and then them sneak in some other laws in the back door, right? And then after the big law go through, because you mind it, You're concerned about the big, genuine headline story. We're trying to protect psychological impact. So you get caught up in that, and then when you read the blueprint, you realize it just get what you don't get. Perfect example, a master of this is Uncle Sam. After what happened in New York in September 2001, Uncle Sam bringing us the laws. Because they were like, oh, you didn't see what happened to me? Alright, we need them laws here. Right? And the big headlines, right, were all about protecting the people and see. But No, for the little small fine print them. But nobody never look upon it because they look upon the big headline stories. They sneak in some other little laws. Where to this day are affecting Americans and their privacy. This is how governments operate. Smoke screen. Big headline. Oh no man, I feel help you, man, I feel protect you. And then you sneak in, right? The spooky fine print. So when they see this boy, oh, protect the psychological. The videos of shootouts or man, you know, 87's character option or Maxwell or whatever. It's not like so these are being broadcasted on TVJ and CVM, on 7 o'clock news and 8 o'clock news, and nobody, you can't, you have a seat. It's not like, say, you walk down the road and on billboards in Arfitry and Crossville and downtown, you're seeing these videos. These videos are being sent phone to phone. Yo, dog, check out this. Yo, you know you're going now, so look on this. And people go, hey, let me see it. Even, for example, with my videos, if me say, I have the video of this, I go on it there, so people have to go look for it. That's a choice that adults can make. This is not being forced by nobody. So, oh, you want to bring in tougher laws to your bender because of the psychological impact it may have on recipients. One definitely realize what I'm going to say. You know what? I'm carry on. I'm play an next part of the clip. Because this video might be 20 minutes, it might be 20 hours, I don't know. Let me see. Listen up.
We propose the inclusion of a provision that makes it an offense to deliberately make a false publication over a digital platform with the intent to commit or facilitate the commission of an offense. False publications have led to misinformation, outrage through deception, incitement of violence, and in some instances, physical, financial, and or reputational damage. I recall from the last meeting of this committee, there was a very robust debate about the reputational damage that can be caused by misinformation spread via digital platforms and the lack of appropriate redress to the victims of this kind of activity.
Yeah, well, guess what? We don't believe you. You need more people. You think this law come in for the handcart man? You think this law come in for the taxi man, for the bus driver? You think this law, right, is coming in for the ordinary Jamaican walking up and down upon the road? This law is to protect the people at the very top. Both reputational damage. You see what happened with the Minister of Health, Christopher Teflon, when they put him on IG and put out, say, our woman marketing campaign, him woman work for. That's the kind of things they want to stop. That is the kind of things they want to stop. Because the government cannot control new media. What is new media? You have old media and new media. Old media is the traditional outlets. You see them at TVJ, Gleaner, your Observer. Those organizations, the laws are very tight in what they can say. This is why every now and then they hear them in a courthouse and all kind of things. New media, where them can just get a politician file and dash it out there, that is your favorite politician's worst nightmare. You think they're bringing in laws because of your reputation? Because of the reputational damage. This amendment to the law is a criminal's best friend. This, your favorite criminals all over, I mean, I talk about, you know, your high, especially your high level, popular, successful, whether they're in the politics or in the entertainment, they are loving this amendment. They are clapping their hands right now. Because this is who is going to get protected by this. You see, the concern, right, about people putting out this and putting out that, is not like say it's not real now. Yes, it's real. It is real. So this is why I say, then bring out a real issue and then backdoor, right, the thing what them really want to get rid of. So people are going to say, well, you know, that sounds reasonable. You know, we can't just have people go on the internet and call out Christopher tell Flan like that, you know, he's reasonable, right? Alright, so you bring in the law now, and then you stifle all of that. You stifle all expos. Guess what? Sure. You might protect this person who, reputational damage, but then you, who you really shield, is your politicians, your entertainers, your favorite CEOs and your big shots, right? Because they would also be protected by this law. No, them cannot get exposed. Because somebody who would expose them is now worried, so they're going to want 20 years of jail. Right? I mean, I give you the timeline where they push back to move it from to what? You're not going to hear the sentence that they talk about. Right? So now, people who might say them favorite politician, I do something we enough to do. I go say, whoa, that sentence they look kind of serious, you know. Is it worth it? I don't even realize how dangerous this is. There's a reason I'm up the Press Association of Jamaica, right? Because that body, right, is what them say, a free press, oxygen of democracy. That body is the body where, as far as I'm aware, can at least ask the government, yo, let me see what I want. So, we could look on the fine print. You see, any of the government have the ability, if you don't say, you know what, you can't say this, because they hear how broad the terms are. Right? When them say falsely, people of Jamaica understand what I'm going on. If politician A a thief money, or politician A have a bag of pitney, what am I do things with? And somebody know that. And drop that file. Because it is not in a court of law, technically it's false. Unless it is proven in a court of law, it is false. And how much people are going to carry things in a court of law go win the case? How much people are going to stand up in a court of law and testify against a politician? Or testify against a big shot in the TNR? Or testify against a big shot CEO and a businessman and a businesswoman? Or a big shot done? Or a 116? How much people are going to do that? Not many. So people turn to the internet for throw file. And the government know this. So by cutting off this avenue, your favorite 116th is safe. You think this is about protecting you? Reputation. You hear what I'm saying? Inside violence. Everything is done for security. Because when you hear that now, when you hear about, inside violence, where are these cases? Show them now. Show me these cases. Outrage through deception, incitement of violence, and in some instances, physical, financial, and reputation. Where are these hundreds of cases? Right? To the point where we are saying, no man as a society, we need to do something about this. The people are not asking for this. Like, we're not finding it spooky. The people are not asking for this. Like, Adam Agid. You come like you just wake up, you go outside, and when you look, you see one roast breadfruit in front of your yard, and you don't ask nobody for nothing. Where does it come from? No, we just feel say need. Nobody ever asked for this. The people have not asked for this. The Jamaican people are not asking for an amendment in the law. And them are pushing because they're going to benefit them. When this is a nonsense towards a con artist in this. The Press Association of Jamaica have the clout and the, I guess, the quote unquote legitimate, right? Powers are, I don't know if they have any legal powers, but we know them can check the government in some respect, at least ask questions, right? Because of course they're not going to listen, right, to somebody like me, you know, like a YouTuber, right, who just bad mind scammers and fight against artists, but the Press Association of Jamaica, they have a look at talk. So the people in my dung there, right, if you make themselves useful to the Jamaican people and push back against this. And old media, the Gleaner, the Observer, TVJ, CVM, them need to say something too. a matter of fact, if they don't say nothing, then as far as I'm concerned, they are part of it. They're agents. Because if they don't say nothing, because they want to show about new media. That's how me I look on it. Because nobody in the field of journalism and media should see this and hear this and them eyebrow no raise. What do you mean share a video of violence and the psychological impact it have on the rest? So if I shoot up one half a tree and people start sharing the video, what? What if them need to explain this law? Because maybe I just do it all vague, maybe it just sounds so vague why me not get it, so they need to break it down further. Because I can't just sharing a video. Yo, look on the video, we're going to Maxfield, three people, check it out. Alright, what a charge. Can't jail? Nothing can go so. No sanction can go so. What kind of democracy is this? That's not a democracy. A banana republic that. Won't take this thing for. Next thing I'm going to tell you, how are you going to enforce this law? Because I want things for bringing a law, but how do you enforce this? The government cannot enforce this unless they have some kind of access to what people are doing on their phone. Because if me I share, if I may share this and I share this to 3, 4, 5 man, if unless I'm a friend them or my family them, obviously they're not going on the station go say officer, you know, say, Sir Peter sent me this video of the shootout down a town, go lock him up. Let's face that not gone. So all the government are gonna enforce it. A group of bridges are share some videos amongst themselves. All the government are gonna be able to intercept, if you see them and share it, and then to enforce the law to go charge them. How? This is what I'm telling say, it's never as it appears, there must be more to it. None of them things that I'm bringing, them are gonna need data, am I gonna need information, am I gonna need names, am I gonna need this, am I gonna need address, and if you know where to go, who send it, how do I get that? Without bringing in other laws, we say, well, we're gonna need to know this now because in order for bringing in the law, we have to understand what's going on. I notice how quiet this is, as I said, this is probably the first time you hear it, right? That's because the Jamaican public are too busy caught up in the entertainment. Right? The laws that won't affect them, they don't see them. Right? The laws that are capable of changing the very fabric of our society, they don't see them because they're too busy to worry about who they with who, which entertainer breed for who, and who go over here, so, and me say, him get born with chi, and me say, that's what Jamaican people are worried about. So that's why the government can sneak in and look at things under the quiet. Right? Just a little small post on IGR, nothing major. Right. That way down the road, people say, then when this come out, they say, well, you never see the post. A couple years ago, a year before, they didn't see it. And then people realize how dangerous this is. Now, as for the type of sentence that I'm looking for, I'm going to read this directly for IGR. Deputy DPP Andrea Martin Swaby told the parliamentary committee that the maximum penalty, right, for cybercrime is 7 years if tried in the circuit court and 4 years if tried in the parish court. Go on to state that, right, the Proceeds of Crime Act, the maximum penalty can be handed down by a judge is 20 years, whereas the maximum under the Cyber Crimes Act is 7 years. And she go on to state, say, the NCB manager will just get charged, Andrea Garden. But the reason why she couldn't get a bigger sentence is because she get tried basically. One of the charges was under cybercrime. So, them couldn't really do much because, first of all, what have to do with this? See, this is them. They keep bringing in things that now have nothing to do with nothing. We are break this down piece by piece. Cybercrimes Act is a broad act. When they move Cybercrimes Act as a whole from 7 years to, for example, 15 years or 20 years, then that means that somebody who get charged under the act, for example, sharing a video, can then get the maximum sentence. Andrea Garden and cases like that need to get broken down and separated. It can't be a broad cyber crimes act. If people realize how spooky this is, go check it out on Andrea for yourself. I don't even know why that case was used as an example. We are talking about the part about sharing video, the laws that I'm trying to amend about sharing videos, right, and calling out man and exposing man. If Cyber Crimes Act as it stands is 7 years, because it's not like you can get time now, 7 years, right? But when Cyber Crimes Act as a whole jump from 7 years to 20 years, or 30 years, however long, that means that when they get charged, right, for sharing, whatever it is, because you call psychological impact on the recipient, you are liable to be at the mercy of a judge for sharing one video, for sharing one shootout on a wall cam. Come on. I don't see what's going on. So this needs to get broken down in a small pieces and addressed piece by piece. Yeah. And we know them now go come out and directly respond to this video. Yeah. So the Press Association of Jamaica, who have the clout and have the respect, right, from official, quote unquote official places. Because they know even them come over here and take entire stories, like, you know, the Yekak Walker story and the bedbugs, that them they give me credit for that. So imagine something like this, they might go like them, you know. Not care how good this video do. This video could have do 10 million people could have seen this video, they might go like them see it. So the Press Association of Jamaica, them need to tackle the government on this. Ask the questions, what this mean? Nobody would know vague term, brother. This is too vague and open, and oh, you can take it away. We need it brought down piece by piece. What exactly this mean? And what gonna happen if this happen? These are spooky times. Spooky, spooky times. Anyway, because it will come out, I mean, now government, it made a difference to me. Would that want me 100 years, it don't make no difference to me whatsoever. But you know, so enough people are going to get turned off. Enough people are going to get free. Enough people are going to be deterred, right, from, you know. So, it needs to. If you get clarified, I'm not going to see what comes of it, no. Anyway, Patreon squad. You open yourself. PIA, you don't know. More life. Vulture Squad, stay circling. Bless.